Live in HD from the station that brings you more West Texas news. News West 9 at 10 starts now.
The alert is going out across the basin as the West Nile virus continues its spread across West Texas.
Now, the mosquito-carried disease is in not just one, but at least two West Texas counties, and doctors are now working to warn the public.
Nick Lawton joins us live to tell you what's next to stop it from spreading. Nick.
Mike and Crystal, many West Texas eyes are on the sky tonight when dealing with the West Nile virus. We're up to seven cases in our area spanning multiple counties, and doctors say this spread is not unexpected. So are the cities going to start rolling out the big guns? And by that I mean start spraying for mosquitoes from airplanes, spraying before more people wind up here at Odessa's Medical Center Hospital emergency room. At first, Medical Center Hospital in Odessa had only treated four West Nile cases out of Andrews County. On Tuesday, they treated their first Ector County case.
It's not unexpected. The counties are very close by. We do expect some migration of disease.
Outside the hospital, the West Nile count stretches higher.
I recently checked about 30 minutes ago, and so we're still at three cases.
Now West Texas hospitals are alerting each other each time a case emerges, trying to grab a handle on a disease that could have gained ground from the West Texas heat.
There was a really mild winter, which the winter usually kills off the mosquitoes.
One question on a lot of West Texas minds is, are we going to start taking our mosquito spraying to the sky, like bigger cities like Dallas are doing? Officials with both cities of Midland and Odessa said airplane spraying isn't being planned, but crews are still working, responding to people's calls about where the most mosquitoes are and spraying those areas down. Meanwhile, health officials have recommendations.
Mosquito repellent.
Wear long sleeves if possible. Dusk and dawn, try to stay inside as much as possible.
Pails of water left outside for the animals or the dogs to get access to, those can be potential breeding spots.
West Nile can range from no symptoms to normal flu symptoms to something much worse.
The neuroinvasive disease there is that disease where you get meningitis and swelling of the brain.
But there's good news on that front.
Only one in about 100 infections ultimately results in neuroinvasive disease.
Now, even though aerial sprays are not in the plans for the moment, cities are still encouraging you, the people, to call them in and let them know of any problem areas, areas where there are the highest concentrations of mosquitoes. So give them a call. Let them know what address you saw the highest concentration of mosquitoes at. Give them the corner roads. Give them where you saw the mosquitoes so they know where to send their sprayers and where to go to try to stop the spread of the infection. For now, reporting live in Odessa, Nick Lawton, News West 9.